You are watching OK News with me, Herwin Ananda. We will bring you the most updated news from all around Indonesia. The Indonesian Broadcasting Commission is in hot water after an employee came forward with allegation of bullying and sexual harassment. On Wednesday, a statement was reportedly written by a man identified as MS was widely circulated on social media. MS wrote in the statement that the bullying and sexual harassment he experienced started not long after he joined the commissions. He went on to name 8 men, all of whom are believed to be active cafe employees who harassed him on multiple occasions both inside and outside the cafe's office. MS has tried to report the bullying and sexual harassment he experienced to his supervisors and also to the police, but there was no response. However, after the MS open letter went viral, the KPI commissioners immediately formed an internal investigation to investigate this case. KPI also directly assist MS in making a report to the Central Jakarta Metropolis. The police also immediately moved quickly to investigate this case. The Central Jakarta Metropolis have scheduled summons to 8 KPI employees suspected of sexually harassing MS. The Central of the KPI is still investigating the alleged perpetrators of sexual harassment and bullying that happens in the Indonesian Broadcasting Commission office. According to the head of the KPI, if they are proven to do the violation, there will be strict punishment from the KPI itself. However, he didn't want to explain more about what punishment would be given to them. Viewers, recently the performance of the police has become a public concern following the viral hashtag Percuma Lapor Polisi. This hashtag appeared at the same time as the upload of the Project Multa Tuli report, which recounted a mother complaint that the case of alleged rape that happened to her 3 children was not followed up by the East Luwu Police South Sulawesi. On 6 October, Project Multa Tuli put out a nearly 3,000-word report on a mother's desperate attempts to get justice for the rape of her 3 children, which is all of them are under the age of 10. The sexual assault was allegedly perpetrated by her ex-husband, who is the children's biological father. The mother, who used the pseudonym Lydia in the Multa Tuli report, learned about the incident from her eldest child. Her 2 other children later said that they had been raped. Even though that the hashtag is in the context of the East Luwu Police sector in the South Sulawesi Police, but the existence of the hashtag can reduce public trust toward police. The Indonesian Police Watch or IPW argued that the viral social media hashtag Percuma Lapor Polisi should be momentum for the evaluations. Okay, we move to the international news. Last week, scientists in South Africa and Botswana detected a new strain of the coronavirus, one with about 50 mutations across its genome. By contrast, other variants such as Delta variant have less than 20 mutations. Known as Omicron, the new variant has put the globe on alert. Since 24 November, when it was first reported to the World Health Organization, health officials have now detected Omicron in more than a dozen countries across at least 5 continents. The variant poses a very high risk. Over the past 2 weeks, Omicron has spread to at least 7 of South Africa's 9 provinces, quickly overtaking the country's outbreak, and thus it appears outcompeting Delta variant. It is still unclear whether current vaccines are effective against Omicron, but the authorities still recommend that people get booster vaccines. A number of countries have imposed travel restrictions on South Africa and neighboring countries.
Well, viewers,
That is the end of our morning news for today. So thank you for watching. I'm Herwin Trenanda. Stay safe everyone and have a great day.